Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and in this video, I am going to show you how you can use named colors. So let's get started. Yes, named colors. This is a new feature in iOS 11 and above, of course, and you can find it in Xcode 9. Now, the feature of named colors is to make your coding business much easier. But before we dive into the details, I will show you how I and most of us coders used to do this before named colors. And for that, let's just start off by opening a new Xcode project. So let's create a new project. And I will create game because everything is a little bit stranger in SpriteKit, and I want you to know how this is done inside a SpriteKit project. So I will just name the product name and choose for the language Swift. Okay, let's click on next and finally put it on the desktop. I will create a new folder here. Let's create the folder, and finally, let's create our project too. Let's say that I want to add to our game scene here. Let me just delete all of this, useless code for our example. Okay, and let's just build and run this on our simulator and see that everything is okay. Okay, and as you can see here, we have the hello world label that I will instantly just delete now because we will not use this. Let's go back to game seed. And now I want to add a sprite. Let me just build and run that. So you may see that everything is clear. I want to add a background color. Okay, and for that, we will need to add a sprite. So let's add here a sprite, let background. And we will initialize it for this time with a color. And that will be a UI color. Let's call it red, and the size should be the size of the view. So view dot scene dot size. And finally, let's build and run, see what this is result. Okay, here we have our reddish background. Okay. That is all good. Now let's try to add a logo. So I will just drag and drop one of my assets here, and I will choose our logo here. Okay, I will just drop it here in my assets catalog, and then go back to the game scene.swift, and let's create let logo equals to sk right node, and this time around we are going to call with the image named, and it will be a logo. I believe that's it. Let me just double check here. Yes, that is correct. And of course, let's just give it a position logo, rename this so logo sprite. Would be much easier to write position equals to cg position to cg point dot, and I will use this zero, but before that, because now we would have the logo down here, I will just go up here and say self dot anchor point. And that will be at the middle of our scene. Okay, 0.5 and 0.5. This way, when we anchor, set the position to CG.0, then the logo should be drawn at the center of our screen. Okay, let's add some new Z positions. So background.zposition equals to 0 now, and let's logo sprite Z position equals to 1, so the logo should be in front of our background, of course. Finally, I believe, let's add child logo sprite. Okay, let's build and run again, and let's see. Maybe we need to shrink a little bit down our logo. Let's see what happens now. Oh, yes, it is much too big. So let me just go here and type in logo sprite scale to set scale, because I want to scale down in proportion. So the scale should be, say, 0.2. Okay, so we should have a nice logo on top of our good stuff here. Okay, now what if we wanted to add a new color to this logo? So let's say logo sprite color equals, let's say, dot. Let's just build and run this, see what. And as expected, well, I knew already, but nothing changed. We don't have a color, but we add it inside our code. That is because we are not using our image as a template image to be, well, our image to be rendered as a template image. But we still need to think of something new, and that is that our logo sprite is actually a texture. So we need to change logo sprite the color blend factor to be not zero, other than zero, and we will add it to be 1.0. Okay, and now let's just build and run again, and let's see what happens. And of course, as you might have guessed, we will still have an error. And okay, this doesn't really look white, so let's just change this, let's say, to yellow. Okay, let's build and run again. And now we will encounter another strange issue. Well, we have written here yellow, but it is actually green. Now, why is that? That is because our main image, our main texture, I would rather say, is a bluish image. And we are giving it a color of yellow with a color blend factor of 1. So what we need to do instead of adding a bluish texture is to add a plain old black or plain old white text image. So let's just delete this. And I have already prepared here our white logo. So let's just drag and drop it here. And of course, don't forget to set the render mode to template image. Okay, this could be done in code as well, but this is far more. Okay, now let's go back to game scene and change the image name to logo white. And now let's just build and run and see if the yellow color occurs. Okay, because the white color, we wouldn't know any changes. There it is. I will just change this to, let's say, well, yellow is okay by this standard. So this is, and maybe we could add black here too. So R, red and black go together very well. Okay, now if you wanted to add other colors, and this is where we will progress to our named colors, we would, let's say, create a constants class, say new file, not a class, just a new file where we would store, let's say, create this. This is where we would store our color. So let's say team color, and that would be, let's go here and the theme color is red. Now, dot red, and of course we need to import UIKit because dot red is actually a UI color, and most probably we need to add UI color here, color dot red, and it is, this is our theme color. So we may go here and select our theme color, change it here this way. So whenever our designer comes in, we can change our theme color easily in a constant, and we don't have to go all in all of our scenes. Okay, next up is, let's say, our LED, and this should be our tint color. Okay, this is all of the colors, let's say buttons, or in our case, our logo, and it will be a UI color dot black. Okay, and let's just out. And now let's go back to the game scene and add it here. Okay, and this is how we change all of our color in our constant. Now, if we didn't want to use, and most probably we will not use these basic colors that UIKit provides, then we would go with something like this. And that is UI color. And here it is. Let's go down and find this red, green, and blue. And here we would go out and find something. Go to our finder. And if you want to get great color schemes, go to colorhunt.co. This is not a sponsored video in any way for Color Hunt. I just really like these stamp color schemes. Let me choose this. Okay, and here you will have the hex value of your color. I really like this one, but the issue, let me just copy this out. But the issue is that with UI color constructor, we have only red, green, and blue, and an alpha value. But fear not, we still have another solution, and that is UI color.xyz. Here, if you just paste in here your hex value, and of course we set alpha to 1. Here we have our Swift code. Okay, let me go to back to Xcode and just enter it here. And let's just build and run and see the changes for now. Okay, good stuff. It's another kind of red that I really like. Let's go back to our Color Hunt page, and I will select this gray one and just simply put it here. And I believe it's changed, and I will just copy this line of code out and change our tint color too. Okay, let's build and run again and see what happens. Okay, maybe I will just this yellow one. Okay, this is just a preference. I will just go on quick. Let's build and run again. Okay, now as you saw, this is a very, very tedious work. Now, what named colors can do for you is eliminate this, all of this copying and pasting, and makes these color changes much, much more easier. Okay, and this is what you need to do. Go to your assets catalog, and let's just create a new colors. Okay, and here you have a color, and I would just name this theme color. Okay, never ever name your color sets brown or light gray or anything like that, because in the meantime, when your designer changes the color, then maybe the blue color will not actually be blue, it will be anything else but blue. So go ahead and select your theme color, and now you can tap on this little square here, and as you can see here, you have the chance to set your color manually. So I would just tap on this one, and maybe select, just scroll this down, and let's just change this. Let's go back to color hunt, and maybe I will just change this to this new template color. Okay, and select the color picker and just simply select your color. So this will be the theme color. Okay, next up we have our tint color, so I will just create a new color set. And we can select this as the other one. Okay, let's color picker, and I will choose this one. Okay, now we have our theme color and tint color. Good stuff. Okay, now let's go back to game scene. And yeah, rather yet, go back to constants. And inside here, we might choose delete all of this. And here comes the magic. We just select our, media library. And here we have our theme color, and we just drag and drop it here. So, and we just select our tint color and drag and drop it here. And it is that easy. Okay, let's build and run again. And there you have it. We have changed our theme color and tint color. Good stuff. For now, if you would like to change these theme colors, let's say we go back to the asset catalog and change this theme color to a new one. We just select this one, color picker, okay. And if we go back to our constants, you will see that none of this has changed. Let's build and run again. So it doesn't really remember this, but I believe this is a bug in Xcode and it will be fixed soon. But as a quick change, we just delete it and drag and drop again. Okay, maybe we just need to restart Xcode again. Quick Xcode. Let's build and run again. Oh, let's start our project again. And now let's delete this, drag and drop our theme color. And this is most probably a bug and it will be fixed in the new version of Xcode. But this is how easy and cool it is to use named colors inside your Xcode projects. So let's just wait for this to build and run on our iPhone X simulator, of course, not on my Rebeloper iPhone. And let's wait for it. And that is it. That's a wrap for named colors. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. And if you liked these videos and want to see more from me, go ahead and click on the subscribe button and maybe on the bell to get notifications in your emails when new episodes are released from me on Rebeloper's YouTube channel. Okay, see you in the next one.